already done with the now we already done with the part where it's laying the pink and the white powder. And the next step, what I'm gonna do is performing the shape of the nail. The shape of the nail, I will ask you, like the customer, Miss Terry, what shape would you like to be now?
This is more like what I do.
So she wanted a square round shape. I'm gonna perform a square round shape for her. Why do I shape it this way? It's because the lady, they look at her hand this way.
Yeah.
So I shape, actually shape in yellow. But I will ball hand from the bottom to make sure both sides is balanced out yet.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I never had it done that like backwards way.
That is actually the right way of shaping, is because you shape in the customer view of performing now.
So how come you left Atlanta?
Oh, it's a long story, you know.
Yeah.
I think a better opportunity over here, school system and everything is good for my baby.
How old?
5.
Aww.
So I want to come over here, so it's a better opportunity for me.
I remember those days. Mine are 24 and 22 now.
Girl.
Yeah.
Give the customer a little bit more on the style to look more natural and more natural. There is actually things that they want to see the hand from their view at least. It's where I better leave it for looking. Thank you. even it look natural in the other way, which is your way, but also you care about other people look at your nail mm-hmm. too. So make sure both view is perfect. Mm-hmm. You know, so. This part is that you're gonna make sure that the white line is, the cuticle is mush and the white line is defined. So you're gonna clean out the cuticle. First of all, you're gonna push the cuticle upper to separate the nail from the nail bed. Yes. When I perform the powder, I perform very close to the cuticle, but it's not on the cuticle. So it's longer time for it to grow out. But first, I'm going to trim on the bottom so it looks more natural. On every nail, I trim a bit. So on the bottom, it does not see any thickness. It not mean that I thinned out the nail, but I just make a trim. So the nail bed can look more natural when people look at it. It's like the real nail of the customer. I don't like the fake look. So I will do that on all of that. Because basically it's only a thing that makes the customer as well as others feel uncomfortable about the nail. It's just a light dream will make it look much better. Then I'm gonna dream on the cuticle. I'm gonna perform that. Because I already pushed the cuticle back, so I feel confidently to go on the cuticle, and I'm gonna dream the cuticle for the customer as well. So it won't see any dry cuticle when the customer see it's on their nail. There's nothing on the side, because if there's something on the side, it will make the nail lift. So door separation, so you can take out dip inside. If there's something in there, it needs to be out. Same application applied to this hand. Separate because there's some powder on the skin. So I'm gonna remove that. Put it on right now. Totally. But you make sure that the customer hand is not tense. Because once the customer hand is tense, they control the drill instead of you controlling it. And once they control it, it's easy for you to lose some control, and at that time, it can create the damage. Now, I switch to a different drill where I'm gonna make both of the lines to be five in the pink and the white.
I'm gonna smear it.
That's the thing on this process. It will make them, both of them, look the same. No smear at all.
Okay.
You see that now all the land is
right,
defined.
It's much more defined.
Yes, because still want a manicure?
Do I still want one?
A manicure.
I don't know. It's hard for me to tell. I don't know if I need one now.
After I trim the cuticle on the cuticle for you.
No, maybe after I wash them, I'll.
I will clean them out for you. then they can see whether you need one or not.
Okay. I just hate when they look white. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Anyway, in the end, I'm gonna give you some nourish cuticle oil.
Okay.
But the cuticle, you see, when I perform by the truth, I already take them out.
Yeah, I think it looks fine now. Okay. I think if you put oil on them, I think it'll be all right.
Just drink my water, and maybe you need to use some butter.
Yeah, so I don't drink a lot of water.
Yeah, drink my water. That helps a lot.
Especially now because it's too cold.
Then I'm going to buff a little bit.
I drink a lot of coffee, though.
It's not good. I have a quick coffee.
I drink a lot of coffee.
This one will make them become more stuck a little bit because we're going to perform a gel coating. So I want this one to be stuck a little bit. So once the gel on top of it, it makes it much better. Give a light buff on the bottom.
Okay.
So. Don't leave the buff that much. Only make sure on the bottom is deep fried.
Hey, Nate, let me know what your schedule is. Call me back. Bye.
You're gonna use the IBD one. The current is Intense Show IBD. That's what I'm using.